Welcome to LegalTech 2019. Well, today's not actually LegalTech Day, today's the day before, and I'm just picking up badges for the team. Badges, get your badges right here. LegalTech is gonna start tomorrow, but for you, LegalTech is gonna start in 3, 2, 1. I'm sure you guys know that I'm here at LegalTech on company's time, so it is taking me a little longer than normal to make videos and vlogs for you and so on. Normally I'm in and out in half a day, but because of all the video making, it's probably going to take me all day here. Point is, I want to say thank you to Vdiscovery for putting up with all my extracurricular activities that I do here at LegalTech. So thank you, Vdiscovery. I'm gonna put all the contact information to the most awesome eDiscovery service provider in the Midtown Manhattan. Check them out. It's a little bit of everything. It's a feeling in my bones. So all I wanna do is dance. I just wanna raise my hands. Raise them up to the sky. Let's quickly talk about registration for LegalTech, because something interesting happened over the last few years. Last year, when people registered for LegalTech, some were not able to do so to get a $30 exhibit pass because they had a booth previously. This year, though, it seems like all the vendors were added to like a vendor list. So when you try to register under a vendor name, you're automatically routed to non-exhibiting vendor registration screen, which, you know, is crazy. Like, I don't see how anybody will send members of their team to an event where you got to pay $3,500 per person. And the message on the registration site says it is to protect integrity of the show and to ensure value of exhibit space at LegalTech. And honestly, when this $30 exhibit hall pass was introduced a few years back, there was a lot of hesitation then. And now trying to get $3,500 of people, I don't know. I think the attendance is going to be at the all-time low, especially from the vendor side. But hey, maybe that's how they want it. After a slightly less energetic keynote than last year, I think it's time we check out the showroom floor. I'm gonna tell you a funny story that happened a few years ago. Deals with LegalTech registration again. You know, when you register, you have to give them your email address, and then you start getting all kinds of emails. There's no checkbox to say, don't email me anything. So you have to give them the email address in order to register. So one year, one of my coworkers decided to be really clever about it. So he made a junk email, basically a burner email address. And he called it LegalTech_junk@whatever company, right? So he thought he was all clever. He's going to name it that, delete it after the show. He went into the show. He got his badge, registered, all that. That was fine. And then he went to one of the booths. And at the booth, as you know, they have these scanners where they scan your badge. So they ask, like, hey, can I scan your badge if you want to get some toys? So he's like, sure, yeah, take it. So they went, they scanned it, and he's standing there all smiling, and then the lady after scanning goes, and she just gave him that look, like, clearly she was able to see fake email he was using, so she knew it was a junk email address. And so the look she gave him, I think, made a really long-lasting impression on him after that. Well, at least he learned not to put word junk in a junk email. Another baby just like you, and skip to my darling gentleman. Yeah! We need a miracle, a miracle, a miracle man. We need a miracle, a miracle, a miracle.
Danie's right. Okay, Danie's here, Michael is ready. Now it's a party. Now we can walk around the floor and have fun. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Oh yeah, the bag. It's the bag.
No, it's right there. Now we can get some swag.
Judge, you need one of these in your life. You definitely, maybe
does
two.
Does it help me make decisions?
Absolutely.
So tell me next starting base number.
Yeah. You got a survival kit?
Yeah.
Are you gonna survive?
Well.
Hey, Adrian Lynn.
How are you?
There you go.
How many US dollars is estimated to be paid in rides globally each year?
Michael is doing trivia to get more swag.
What'd you get, Michael?
What are the answers?
That's all you got.
I got a beastie pet. So fast. So, you should go. Hi.
So I'm here on LegalTech floor, and I want to talk to you guys about one thing that that's been coming up year after year. And it seems like people kind of down on LegalTech lately. I am seeing less attendees now after lunch. And one of the things I hear from people when I say, hey, are you guys going, you know, and they're like, yeah, I don't know, maybe I'll skip this year. And it does feel like people have lost enthusiasm for it. Now, as far as me, I never had a lot of enthusiasm, but I do enjoy attending. I'm not going to hide it. I like walking around the exhibit hall. I like seeing what different vendors are up to. I definitely enjoy meeting people from the industry, someone who I've talked to on social media, and meeting them and seeing them, meeting new people and seeing existing people, talking face to face. That's a big deal for me. I like in-person communications. I hate emails. Anyway, I don't know. Are you still guys excited about LegalTech? Yes, no, maybe. Put a comment below. I don't know. Well, that's going to do it for me for today. I'm going to head back to the office and see what kind of fun things evening brings.